Jim and the manager, Mr. Sitara. On behalf of Sitara, I extend warm welcome to each one of you on today's webinar on inspection of city offices. To take up this session, we have Sri N. Sundar, AFA Training Sitara. About Sri N. Sundar, he holds a bachelor degree in commerce from Usmani University, Hyderabad. He has rich experience in different topics of accounts branch for having worked in various sections in his 30 years career. Before coming to Sitara, he also worked as ADFM Nanded and also ADFM Hyderabad Region South Central Railway. Today's topic, inspection of exit offices, is a strong question, Appendix 3A. I'm sure this session will be very beneficial to Appendix 3A and NDC aspirants. Thank you all, have a nice day. And I hand it over to Sri N. Sundar, AFA Training Sitara. Thank you, Mr. Bender, for the wonderful introduction that you have given and both me. Short question in even the Appendix 3A examinations. Now, one of the most important functions of the accounts office is to inspect on the spot the source documents maintained in the executive offices which are not sent to accounts office for check. The main object of the inspection is to ensure that the vouchers and returns submitted by these offices to the accounts office have been correctly prepared, are maintained efficiently, and can be produced in a court of law should an occasion arise. There are instances where an aggrieved employee is forced to go to the court when his grievance is not solved. In such cases, the court will definitely ask us to produce the original and basic records, and these records are maintained in the executive offices and should be in such a condition that we should be able to produce the same in the court of law as per the orders of the court. So this is one of the most important documents, and as these documents are not sent to accounts office, the basic original documents have to be checked while we go for an inspection of the executive offices. These initial records based on which the claims and returns are submitted to accounts office should be thoroughly checked during local inspection. As these are not submitted to the accounts office for internal check, and these are only kept in the accounts in the executive offices. While carrying out the inspection, it is very, very essential that all these source documents are thoroughly verified so that the information which is sent to the accounts office for internal check is totally correct. Inspection of documents and vouchers which are under routine check of the accounts office should be avoided. While undertaking the inspection of the executive office, normally all the vouchers and returns which are submitted to the accounts office and which a copy of which is available in the account in the executive office should be avoided, because these are anyhow subjected to internal check in the accounts office. Inspection of the executive offices is generally restricted to test check, as it is necessary that the examination of books and records should be conducted thoroughly and very critically. And this is necessary to ensure that any defects in procedure, either through ignorance or external causes or deliberately, which is done by staff and has a bearing on the financial interests of the railways, should be rectified immediately. The inspection of the executive office is an opportunity for the executive to clear their doubts regarding the existing orders and rules which are circulated by the headquarters office or the railway network, and the inspection staff should concentrate on the lapses and issues and play the role of a friendly critic. They should not go into a confrontational approach with the executive officers or their staff, as we should be guided to them than being the critic of what they have done. A large number of supporting documents submitted to accounts office for internal check are not original records. Its efficiency depends on the degree of care exercised by the departmental staff for the accuracy of original records. As I already just told you a short while back, many of the documents which are submitted for internal check are based on original records which are kept in the executive office. The only copies of the rules are sent. For examples are extracts of SARS, which are just sent for, day fixation is done for a SAR. As the original SAR is maintained in the executive office, which is a little far away from the digital accounts office or the headquarters office, these are susceptible to check only when we go on a local inspection of that concerned office. It is also necessary to review the original records to ensure that the degree of care exercised in the executive or the accuracy of such records that are maintained in the prescribed form and are up and on to date. It is also necessary that the check on vouchers and accounts are not submitted to internal check should be adequately checked for its accuracy during such local inspection. The inspection of executive office headquarters and divisions to ensure the accuracy and authenticity of the transactions rendered by the executive. This is most important because all the basic original records are not sent to the accounts office, and to ensure the accuracy that everything is as per the rules and orders which are prescribed, it is most essential that the thorough check is made of the initial original records, which are the source documents which are maintained in the executive offices. The accounts office is required to inspect the executive offices at headquarters and divisions, including the attached offices of workshops and construction accounts. This is generally done by the headquarters inspection section, which has a jurisdiction over all the divisions of the zone. They will select the offices, and the program is circulated in advance, and based on which the inspection team will go on the report on the designated date. Stores balances, which are held by store depots and custodians of local land construction organizations. The inspection of these are done by ASVs and ASAs under the direction of the KNCO SNW. Station accounts inspections are done by DIAs under the direction of the KNCO team. The most important thing about the account inspection field offices is this is the only branch of railways which is empowered to check on the accounts of all the executive offices under their control. No other executive office will conduct a check on the records of accounts office. The only office which is empowered to check the accounts of the records of accounts office is audit, which comes under the CA and the AG. Of course, vigilance can check the records of any office, and their check is totally to ensure that there are all the systems and all the procedures are being followed correctly. The headquarters inspection section is generally under the charge of DPCUT and under the administrative control of DFA, whereas in construction accounts, it is under the administrative control of DFA construction. In the inspection divisions and workshops, they work under the administrative control of the senior DFMs and WAOs. Responsibilities of the headquarters inspection section. The headquarters inspection section is responsible for inspection of all the executive offices under the control of headquarters office. Inspection of they can also undertake inspection of the divisional accounts offices or any of the office, executive offices under the division, the virtual accounts offices, and the unit account offices and construction accounts offices. They are also responsible to check the staff canteens and bookstall accounts. Training centers and education institutions under their control headquarters will also be checked by the inspection section of headquarters office. All general policy matters on the conduct of accounts inspection will be done by the inspection section of headquarters office. Apart from this, the examination of the annual program of inspection received from the divisions are thoroughly checked before communicating the approval of PFA for the same. Responsibilities of inspections of divisions and workshops and construction units, the inspection of all the offices under the accounts control of the division, which include railway schools, catering units, food stalls, platforms, and check of OTA and NDA claims of stations and offices under the division and accounts office. The workshop stores and construction accounts offices are responsible for inspection of executive offices under their control. Periodicity of inspections. In terms of Para 1706 of the Code, Accounts Code, the administrative offices and headquarters in the divisions will be inspected once in 2 years. When inspecting the divisional office, it should be ensured that initial accounts of the engineering expenditure, both construction and open line, should be inspected once in a year. The first inspection of a construction division should, as far as possible, be made within 3 months of its formation. This is very essential as large amount of both stores material would have been received in the construction office, and also work would have been in various stages of completion. And as soon as the construction work is handed over to open line, this should be included in the program, and the inspection should be completed as early as possible. While inspecting a divisional office, it should be ensured that to inspect at least one sub-office in case of engineering and two sub-offices which are not in charge of visitor officer simultaneously. All the subdivisional offices of a division should be inspected within the course of 2 years. This is most important because so that all the offices which are at a distance from the headquarters office should be included in the inspection program, to ensure that the rules and regulations prescribed by headquarters office or railway board are followed by the executives' offices which are spread far and wide in the division. The offices which do not have many transactions where miscellaneous cash, issue of passes and PTOs may be inspected once in 3 years. Program of inspection. The program of inspection to be carried out in the course of the following year to be drawn by headquarters inspections for a section and the divisional office and submitted for PFA's approval by 1st of March of the fourth of each year. Generally, a letter is sent to all the executive offices to confirm whether the office, any new office or any new branch has been opened, or alternatively any of the existing offices have been closed. So that this list is updated and sent to the PFA headquarters office for obtaining the approval of PFA. The workshop and construction accounts offices should draw their annual inspection program with respect to approval of the claim CAOs. However, a copy of this program should be sent to the HOD for information, and also to facilitate the headquarters inspection section to draw that program for inspections. Senior DFMs in the divisions, senior DFMs should draw the inspection program of the division covering all the units as per the periodicity of inspection. They should also draw the number of units inspected in the division before finalizing the program. A copy of the program approved by senior DFMs should be sent to headquarters office for information. PFA will select some units for inspection by the headquarters account section, inspection section. While drawing the program, it should be ensured that there is no overlap between the inspection program of audit office with a view to avoid undue strain on the executives. The offices inspected by audit need not be inspected within 6 months by the accounts office. The program of inspection should show the following details. The offices proposed to be inspected during the year, the month of inspection, the date of last inspection, the number of man days involved, the interval of inspection, a certificate that the program has been drawn, in accordance with Para 1706A1 Accountants Report, in consultation with audits, it also be incorporated by submitting the program to headquarters. The notes should also contain a footnote containing the details of completion of the previous year's program. In certain cases, the previous year's program remains in arrears. So the reasons for that arrears in the program, when it is likely to be completed, and the position regarding the issue of inspection notes should also be furnished to the quarters. In case of construction units, the construction accounts inspection section will scrutinize to see that the program covers the offices due for inspection and submit the same to PFA construction, and with this approval, the program will be sent to NCM General for information of headquarters. The approved inspection program, which is approved by the PFA, is communicated to the divisional offices and it should be kept confidential till the notice of inspection is actually issued. This is very important because there should be an element of surprise involved in conducting the examining the inspection, so that any fraud or any irregularity which has been in practice can be easily identified and rectified. If at all the executives have prior knowledge of the inspection program, which is more than a month or so, such irregularities will always be that will be hidden and they cannot be identified by the inspection team. However, before an inspection is taken up, the head of the office should be given at least 10 days notice from the probable date of inspection to enable the staff to keep necessary records ready for the inspection team. This will also ensure that the head of the office is present at headquarters to discuss the results of the with the inspection team. The gazetted officer in charge of the inspection section should generally associate himself with the inspection. And before going on the inspection, the team members should distribute the items to be inspected by the team. The gazetted officer should, as well as the section officer of the inspection section, should select the month for his original record to be verified by the inspection team. The inspection team should obtain a memorandum signed by the section officers, the points requiring special attention or examination on the spot of the records which are not submitted to the accounts office for internal check. This is very, very essential because the problems faced by the section officers or the staff in the accounts office for which original records are in the executive office, this has to be checked by the inspection team. And only when we carry that record of, we carry a memorandum, what all items have to be checked and clarified in the executive. Cases of delay in clearance, any arrears of outstanding items of suspense account are to be discussed with the executive so that this mark can be obtained towards disposal and clearance of the item. During the scope of the inspection, only a percentage of the initial records of the office need to be scrutinized, but the accounts of cash, interest cash especially, should be checked in full. The accounts of store should be checked in full for one selected month, and to the extent of one day's transactions of each month during the period since the last inspection. The scale check statement or unit proposed for inspection should be taken along with the while going through inspection from the accounts office. Details of agreements and works that are in progress of the unit proposed for inspection should be readily available to the inspection team. A register showing particulars of vouchers collected from the accounts office and checked with initial records during the inspection should be recorded to the signature of the inspecting officials. This is very important because once we return back from the inspection of the executive office, all the original vouchers of the collected from the various sections should be handed over back to them for record. A record of items checked should be kept in a separate register as it will facilitate responsibility being fixed for non-detection of frauds and malpractices in time. This is most important because if you do not maintain a register to record the items which are checked, the responsibility of whether it has been detected will not be known. Before proceeding on inspection, the inspection team should collect the references, forms, money value books, install agreements, special sanctions, etc. pertaining to the unit to verify the actual position and correct account. The gazetted officer in charge should normally accompany the team and should monitor the work being done by members of the team. The team should check the interest cash, survey stamps, and review of important case files regarding progress of work, procurement of stores, and the register should be checked by the section officer of the team. All the irregularities and objections noticed during the course of inspection should be noted. Noted down, quoting the rules and orders in support of the objection. This is very important because the executive office might not be aware of the rules, and this should be noted in support of the objection which is raised by the inspection team. Errors of principle and errors in posting other cases of frauds and losses should be brought out clearly, and all important points should be personally brought to the notice of the officer whose office is inspected for suitable action. During the inspection, besides checking the cash and stores, the following also should be verified. A detailed examination to ensure that all the returns, bill statements, and accounts of selected months are checked, submitted to the accounts office, agrees with the original books and records kept in the executive office. This is most important because the original source documents, as the original source documents are in the executive office, and based on which documents, returns and dues are submitted to the accounts office, should be ensured that both of these are tally, so that the internal check submitted by the accounts office is also correct. A test check should be made of the original records not submitted to the accounts office, of the accounts, returns, vouchers, etc. It can be checked adequately except locally since last inspection. It cannot be checked adequately except locally since the last inspection. A general review of procedure relating to initial accounts of receipt and expenditure of cash and stores with a view to make helpful suggestions towards elimination of useless returns and wasteful methods can be made by the inspection team to the executive offices. The inspection team should also assist the departmental officers in all matters affecting accounts, budget, for the financial regularity transaction. This is very important as several of the executive staff would not be aware of the intricate rules and regulations which are issued on a day-to-day basis by the accounts and the department or by the headquarters and various board. So to clarify their doubts, we should immediately assist them in as far as the rules and regulations are concerned. They should also initial with date all the registered documents except service reports examined by them as a token of their check. After the inspection is over, all the irregularities and objections are to be noted down and thoroughly inspected by the registered officer. The important points taken up for discussion by the head of the office are inspected on the spot. The discussion with the head of the office is intended to understand and persuade each other's points of view on every objection and irregularity, and should be free and frank. If satisfactory explanations are forthcoming, the item should be dropped and should not find a place in the inspection report. This is very important as all the clarifications and objection and irregularity which has been noticed during the inspection can be sorted out after hearing the views of the executive, so that these need not find a place in the inspection report. The objection which could not be dropped as a result of the discussion will be issued in the form of inspection report prepared in two parts. The first part should contain major points of major importance, and which will be labeled as part one, and all other items of minor importance to be included in part two. Registers to be maintained by the inspection section. The following registers are to be maintained by the inspection section: to watch receipts and dispose of inspection reports, the audit, accounts and special ledgers from audit, a register of serious irregularities. All serious irregularities which have been noticed during the inspection should be entered in this register and watched to see that the irregularities do not recur and they are clarified, fit the relevant rules and regulations. A register showing recoveries made and the recoveries foregone as a result of accounts inspection will also be maintained in this section. A register showing the outstanding position of the Railway Board inspection reports should also be maintained to monitor that prompt replies are sent to the Railway Board headquarters for further transmission to the Railway Board. A register showing the recoveries made at the instance of audit. Audit during its inspection of the various executive offices will also make its own objections and also advise recoveries to be made because of irregular payments made or not following the rules. All such instances which are of recoveries which are made at the instance of audit will be noted in the register and these should be watched on a regular basis. Register for recording the particulars of the original vouchers collected for check with the initial records also to be maintained. And as soon as the inspection team returns to the headquarters, these should be handed over back to the respective sections. The calendar of returns these registers will be put up to the gazetted officer every month for review. In addition to the registers mentioned above, the inspection section headquarters and division could maintain a register showing the program of inspection as given in Form 9 Annexure C. This register should be produced to the gazetted officer in charge of inspections. And we should then put it up to the Deputy CAO G or the Senior DFMs in the divisions. The unit accounts officers should indicate the position of inspections in the MPR for information of the PFA. An inspecting officer should not confine his hearing to routine items on check, but should take the opportunity of advising and assisting departmental officers in matters affecting accounts and budget, etc. From the information available to him locally, he can offer suggestions bearing on economy and expenditure, untapped sources of revenue, and recovery of railway costs. The inspection should include only a test check of initial records maintained in executive offices. It need not mean it should not be a detailed check as the detailed checks are done only during internal check in the accounts office. Apart from reviewing the financial records and transactions, a selected item should be checked in its entirety, namely purchase of material, repairs of equipment, whether operational practices are being followed or not, which are causing loss to the railways. This should be verified in total. The check also should be made on the internal controls related to the executive are being followed, and a review of the progress of works within the jurisdiction being proposed for inspection. The inspection team should also concentrate on works and stores which provide ample opportunities for malpractices. Examples of such things are irregularities are committed in stores, accounts, and works, contracts, like consumption of stores, excess issue of stores for which the contractor is not charged, etc. Sometimes the work is closed before completion and subsequently the agency is again asked to execute the balance of work within that period, which these checks can exercise when alert to the experienced inspection team. As materials and stores form a very high percentage of railway expenditure, every effort should be made to identify areas where economy can be achieved. Manpower review is one of the most important areas of check. The inspecting officials should also review the staff position and identify the surplus labor if any during inspection. If in the course of inspection an error is detected which is committed by more than one of these, it should not be dealt as an ordinary item of the inspection report. A special correspondence should be initiated to avoid the occurrence of such mistakes. The officer in charge of the inspection should personally examine some important initial records to satisfy himself that the procedure for accounting of cash in stores is followed as per the prescribed rules. This is very important because cash and stores form a major part of the railway expenditures involved. Many leakage will have a very bad effect on the functioning of the executive office. In case of inspection of a newly formed office for the first time, the inspection team should scrutinize procedures adopted and check the receipt in custody, receipt custody and disposal of cash in stores. During the course of inspection, if serious irregularities are noted, namely deviation in policy, interpretation of rules resulting in loss of revenue, increase in expenditure due to wrong application of rules, these should be discussed with the head of the office inspector for remedial action. Likewise, any new practice being followed, if work being implemented in other units, should be highlighted and circulated among other units for information. If different procedures are being followed in different accounting units, the inspecting team can suggest a uniform procedure to be followed by all the units. Inspections should be conducted by officers of or the accounts department at different levels as on a regular and program basis, so as to keep themselves in touch with the position of work, position of workshops, offices, stores, reports placed under their charge. These inspections should inter alia bring out matters which are likely to give rise to unsatisfactory situations, so as to suggest appropriate remedies. If possible, some problem, particular recurring problems, would further call for detailed examination before appropriate solutions are found. In such cases, the inspecting officer should initiate the examination of such problems on with the help of the concerned branches or headquarters in the divisional office. All irregularities and objections to be noticed during the course of inspection should be noted down methodically and discussed with the inspector. The inspecting officer should also discuss important points noted down to the head of the office as far as practicable on the spot. If, however, any objection or irregularity in regard to any point is withdrawn, it should not find a place in the inspection report. At the conclusion of the inspection report embodying all the irregularities and objections for which no satisfactory explanations are forthcoming will be recorded in the inspection report. As far as possible, the draft inspection report should be completed before the inspecting team leaves the office inspector, and it should be finalized until, and it should not be finalized until the officer in charge of the office inspector or any other office on his behalf has been given an opportunity of meeting and discussing it. The report should be as brief as possible, and the points covered in the report should be arranged in a proper manner and serially numbered. The report should be prepared in two parts. The first part should contain only major important items of major importance. All other items being included in the part two. In the event of a particular type of irregularity noticed, the number of offices, a special report should be made to the divisional officer concerned or head of the division according to the importance of for instituting urgent remedial measures. The inspection report should be in simple and polite terms. The inspection report also should be made out in triplicate. One copy should be retained by the accounts office. Another two copies should be sent to the immediate superior of the officer whose office was inspected with a request that one copy may be forwarded to the latter for early remarks to the superior officer. Before forwarding the replies to the immediate superior, should satisfy himself that the remarks are correct and complete, and where necessary, they should be have been amended or amplified to avoid further correspondence. The remarks of the superior officer should be scrutinized and further action that is necessary may be taken under the orders of the accounts officer. Part 1 of the inspection report should also be seen by the deputy chief accounts officer, and the reports of major construction and other offices inspected by the deputy chief accounts officer or those containing important points should be seen by the financial advisor and chief accounts officer. The part 2 of the report should be made in duplicate. One copy should be retained in the accounts office copy, and others sent to officer in charge of the office inspector with the request that irregularities pointed out herein may be rectified and the recurrence of its irregularities guarded against. If a fraud or loss comes to notice during inspection, the nature and extent thereof should be investigated and a report made to the executive officers concerned. Further action should be taken in accordance with the rules laid down in Chapter 11 of the Financial Report. I think I have covered all the major aspects of inspection. Any doubts or queries or your own experiences you can share after unmuting yourselves.
Please discuss a bit more about the disposal of inspection reports part 1 and part 2.
Yes. Part 1 contains major irregularity which is noticed, which is of a very serious nature. Now this should be actually, as I told you, it should first and foremost, the copy of that before finalizing the report should be discussed with the executive office, in charge of the executive office, and once his remarks are taken, if we are satisfied with that, we may consider whether to delete it from part 1, or if it is of major concern or it is a serious irregularity, then we will have to insist that the irregularity is set right at the earliest and steps taken to regularize the irregular transaction which has taken place. Part 2 is of minor nature, so that will be discussed with the executive, and any information or their remarks will be taken, and based on their remarks, the report can be closed.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Any other query?
Please tell about scale check statement.
Pardon?
Scale check statement.
Scale check. Yes, this is a scale check statement is one of the most important documents in the establishment section, because it shows the number of posts which are for which sanction is available, the number of posts which are actually operated, any vacancy which is available in the sanctioned strength. So what happens is, we have, while the inspection team is proceeding to the office to be inspected, its copy of the scale check statement has to be taken along with them so that they can see whether the staff who are operated is as per the sanction of the scale check, and whether there is any excess labor which is operated, so that this should be brought out in the inspection report and also discussed with the executive officer. And in day-to-day passing of the bills and salary bills in the establishment section, this is one of the most important documents verified by the staff passing the bills, so that at a glance of the scale check statement, we will know whether the total number of employees for whom salary is drawn is as per the sanction and scale check which is mentioned in the statement.
No test check.
Test check is done because you cannot do the 100% check of any record in the executive office. Therefore, what the inspection team has to do is select the items and then select a couple of items and do the test check. And the test check is done thoroughly of the item which is selected. And because there in the executive office, it will not be possible because they will have a lot of records and a lot of information, and only district can help us complete the inspection and come back so that as per the program we can proceed for the other inspections.
Sir, please explain theme-based audit, sir.
Pardon?
Theme-based audit. Theme-based audit.
Theme-based audit.
Yes, sir.
Actually, I am not covering audit. Anyhow, that theme-based audit is a new concept actually which has come now. And I'll have to require little more time for studying that and then explaining to you. Most probably in the next class I'll do that. Any more questions?
Please check in the chat box, sir.
Okay.
Some queries is there.
Yeah. I'm going to check in accounts office regarding work of submitted for refund of SD and successful in works matters. Well, as soon as some works are completed, when the contractor would like to take back his security deposit. So generally what happens is, no objection, no claim certificate is submitted by the office, executive office, and also total work completion completed in all respects. That is, the executive will certify that all the works related to that, all aspects of the work have been completed. Once the executive certifies that all works have been completed and there are no things to contact, is refunded back to the matters.
Sir, regarding to what you said now, is hello, is audit clearance required for refund of SD?
Audit clearance, sir. Yes, because sometimes what happens in the audit during the internal check, they will also rent some amount which has to be recovered as penalty or which has to be recovered during the course which has been overpaid or something like that. So what we generally do is, if there is no other amount to be recovered, if all the payments have been made to the contractor and only SD is to be recovered, then we will make a note saying that this amount has been recovered at instance of audit and the recovery will be effected and subsequently the security deposit will be released to the partner.
Is there any authority anywhere that the audit clearance is a must certificate prior to refund of SD, sir?
There is no such this one, as far as my knowledge was, that audit has to give clearance. Generally speaking, we obtain the clearance because it's a security deposit is the last amount which will be held with us. And if at all, we release the security deposit and subsequently the party, there is some amount to be recovered which cannot recover. Therefore, we see to it that audit clearance is taken and then only we release the security deposit. In case they all advise us to recover some amount, we recover the same amount from the security deposit and then release the balance to the contractor.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yes. Tell me. Yes, please.
Hello.
Yes. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, please.
Good. Sir.
Srinivasanji, please talk to the faculty.
Sir, you told about the inspection report part 1 and part 2.
Hello.
How okay. These are settled?
I am not able to get what you are asking.
Sir, he is asking how to settle the part 1 part 2.
Yes. Actually, after the report is finalized, part 2 will be generally minor items which are included in part of the inspection report. So what happens is, suppose for example, some voucher is not given, we will ask them to give that voucher and then close that, that para will be closed, or some procedure has not been followed, or some entry has not been made. All these things we will just discuss with them initially before finalizing the report. And once they comply with those objections or with those observations which we have made in the inspection report, we will, and if it is satisfactory, we will close those concerned item or concerned para. If it is not satisfactory, we will ask them to enforce the recovery or follow the due procedure. As far as major items are concerned, these are discussed at the by the head of the office inspector with the accounts officer, and after due clarifications from both the sides, if at all there is a serious irregularity has to be rectified, the same is advised to them so that in future such repetitions do not take place.
Will this figure in MPR?
Yes, MPR will figure, inspection reports will figure in MPR. Every month when the MPR is sent to headquarters, they will also know the inspection reports, the status of inspection reports, because you cannot have the inspection report pending for a long time. The action has to be taken with executive and the inspection report closed as early as possible.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Any more doubts, clarifications?
What are the basic difference of say done by accounts and audit and vigilance?
Well, generally speaking, it is more or less same, because all the three wings do the same thing. Only thing is, we ensure that the same office is not inspected within a short period. Like suppose, for example, an office is inspected by audit in the month of say June 2021. The accounts inspection will take place and they will point out all their observations, which will be similar to what we have also done. So what happens is, we immediately see to it that we, at least for next 1 year, we do not go for inspection to the same office. And we also ensure that all the points which the audit has raised in their inspection report are complied with by the executive, because this is most important. If they do not comply, and again the next time when the accounts inspection goes there, if the same points are not adhered to or not cleared, then there is no point in conducting regular inspections. Therefore, this audit inspection is also, the executive is also reminded to ensure that all the observations made by audit in that inspection is catered to. And this, likewise, same thing happens in accounts inspection. Audit also will see that all the observations which have been made during accounts inspection are also attended to by the executive office. Vigilance has their own rules for a check, and that involves slightly different this one. But overall, what happens is, as soon as an inspection is over, they have to see that the points which are raised or in the inspection reports are cleared as early as possible by complying with all the observations made therein. Okay.
What is the difference between inspection letter and part 1 inspection report?
Yeah. Special letter is given by audit, where any item of verification is of a little serious nature. They will first make audit observations, and once the audit observations are replied to satisfactorily, the audit observation is closed. Wherever the inspected item is of a serious nature, they will convert it into a special letter, which has to be replied to as early as possible by the.
But inspection report is also a serious nature.
Inspection report is given by account section, where a special letter is given by audit. That is the main difference. Hello? Hello?
Hello, sir.
Yeah, tell me.
Sir, a special letter is given by the audit section.
Yes. Yes.
Part 2 and part 1. Like inspection letter 1 and
yes.
2.
Yes.
Part
yes.
1, part 2.
Yes. Yes. One more point which we will have, the inspection team can easily identify or easily find out in any executive offices. There are some agreements which are generally closed agreements, or agreements which are to be closed, which are quite old. Why these agreements are not closed, we have to inspect, we have to verify during our inspection. In many cases, what happens is, the major the payment of that contract must have been made to a major extent. Only a minor amount will be pending, and the executive will not close the, will not make that payment, and hence the agreement will still be shown as pending. Such items of agreements which are pending for long years have to be noted down by the inspection team, and also there should be regular correspondence with the executive to close such long pending and old agreements. And also in some cases when cash awards used to be given in cash form, of course today it is all given through salary. When it used to be given in cash form, the amount would be generally booked to MARE. So what would happen is this the acquittance will not be given by the executive, because cash would already be taken in the next financial year during the railway week awards. And what happens is when they do not give the acquittance, this will be shown as a pending item. These items should be scrutinized when inspecting the exhibit box. Any other queries, please?
Participants, how should we wind up the session? If you have any doubts, please ask. Sir, shall we wind up the session, sir?
Yeah, I think there are no queries, no doubts. Yes. I hope some of the staff who have participated can share their experiences of inspections, if at all they want to share. Anyone willing to share their experiences, please? Okay.
Okay, sir, I think no one is good to share. Thank you, sir. On behalf of Chitra, Sitara, again, I thank you for the session for inspection of exit offices. We have interacted with the participants and cleared many doubts, not only in accounts inspection but also audit inspection. Thank you so much, sir. Dear participants, tomorrow's webinar is on accountant or journey of a rupee from booking office to Reserve Bank of India. The speaker is Mr. M. Nageshwar Rao, senior instructor Sitara. Login time is 11 o'clock. The session starts at 11:30. Thank you all. Have a nice day.
Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.